Here we are back for round two, and we got the bye. Pretty irate about it. Signed up for a Swiss draft, man, and we have a sweet deck, Sigil Starship, Starfish, Brew. But, oh well, I mean, we should get another go at it next round, and it's fine to lose sometimes, I think. We're really pushing the limits, or exploring the limits of what's possible in Triple Journey, and then maybe these are could be build arounds for full set draft. Now, full set draft has generally been very aggressive, generally hard. It's been hard for people to draft control decks. And I'm wondering if Journey changes that. I don't know that it does, but in Triple Journey, I'm definitely trying it. Seems okay. I mean, my initial thoughts are, did we get unlucky? Well, we have a hard time dealing with fat with this deck. We've got a couple counter spells and not too much hard removal. That doesn't necessarily speak to control, it speaks to our deck, but those are my thoughts initially, and join you back in round three. Alright, so we didn't get the bye, which is awesome. We get to play a match, and we also won the die roll, and we don't have a scryfish, but this hand's a keeper. I don't know, every time that we don't have a turn two starfish, I'm tilting off, like, with not, what, eight islands? Only eight islands? And how many? Four starfishes? We should have a higher rate. I don't know. It's fine. It's fine. Calm down, TWoo. Calm down. It's just a game of magic. It's just a sigiled starfish. Everything's gonna be fine. I'm tilting off. It's hard not to, but I don't know. This hand seems good. We're not under any pressure, so everything's going fine. A little bit flooded. I mean, yeah, we're a little bit flooded, but should have time. Cards we have should buy time. Pensive Minotaur. Can't deal with that. Guy's gonna dominate the board. With each turn, I get more at peace with the world and happier with each draw step. Mogi's Warhound. That's actually problematic. Like, that guy's would be too big, I think, so let's counter it. Check out if the opponent's playing color other than red. But yeah, Countermand is not good. What? Oh. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's just a counter spell. But I don't know. I think that that's kind of what the deck wanted. I just like counter spells. I like the idea of decking people. That hasn't happened. I don't think it's going to happen. But counters are okay. I mean, I think that this format's slower, or rather... Sure. I don't know if I'd say the format is slower. Yeah, we're gonna have to kill that at some point, probably with two cards. But there's more early game reactive stuff. So, I'm not gonna play it. I'm gonna keep up Countermand and probably counter the next thing just so that we can for sure get rid of this Pensive Minotaur. Pretty embarrassing way to die. Would be. Meanwhile, I swear we have some sigiled starfishes in here and some scry things. We might have. It's like the Descendant's Path video from last week where we didn't draw Descendant's Path. Alright, well, the opponent's playing nothing. Two. Alright, we should have done this ages ago. And using two cards to get rid of two cards seems fine. Knowledge and power, sure. Let's keep it. Although we don't have too much scry power, we do have the Spite of Mogi's, but and we have the Storm Chaser. I decided to keep up Counterman this turn so we could deal with... Do I really want to counter that? Not at all, however, just tempo play. I'm gonna make a play strictly for tempo right now. Just advance the board. Strictly advance the board. And then the question is whether to play Storm Chaser or Knowledge of Power. Storm Chaser is the more conventional play. However, I did a count of the mana, and I like that next turn we're gonna have 7 mana, so we can play Storm Chaser, Spite, and Knowledge of Power potentially. Whereas if we play Storm Chaser, the next turn we'll be short of mana on that. Okay. Nothing from the opponent so far. So far, so good. I assume it's just gonna die. No, maybe not. Oh, the opponent's playing white. That probably explains why they're doing nothing. Okay, here we go. The magic can begin. Okay, that's kind of good. I like it. Seems sweet. Block one and magma spray it. Okay. Here's a land. So we can. This is pretty interesting. I'm kind of interested in passing the turn. Like, I don't want to lose this. No, you know what? Let's kill this and go to the face with Knowledge of Power. And then we can scry. Ooh. This is a good one. And we are not going to have the mana. However, 7 is a big boy. We still haven't seen a sigiled card, and we have 5. I'm still tilting. But Storm Chaser Chimera, which made the table. Crystalline Nautilus, ooh. This card would be hard to beat under normal circumstances. However, these aren't normal circumstances. I'm gonna bottom deck or Mystic. Hey, Sigiled Starfish. It's almost like we put that card in our deck and then we drew it. Almost. Yeah, so Storm Chaser Chimera is a big boy in the late game for sure. Big boy and girl. Boy and or girl. Yeah, fan of the card, definitely. Our big finisher. If I have one complaint, it can end the game too fast. Okay. Yeah, pretty hard to imagine losing at this point with Riddle of Lightning plus Knowledge of Power. Oh my god. Oh my god. Four, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Just a Riddle Blast seems like the way to go. To the dome. We don't need to hit much. Any spell in the top three. Did it. Bottom. Bottom. Top reveal. Nug nug. Game's almost kind of close. Like, it was me misclicking through one attack step away from being a loss, which is kind of close, I guess. All right. Check out the board. Do we have any way to deal with enchantments? No. Okay, hope for mana problems for the opponent again. Sideboarding definitely seems for the newbie. It would be nice to have some more finishers, but oh, we have 6 sigiled guys. Yeah, how do we go a long game without drawing one? Well, I guess we drew one by the end, but furthers my furthers the anger that it burns deep inside of me.